Hi everybody, it's Lynn from wisconsingarden.com and today I am repotting houseplants. Now I have looked at these houseplants for probably 2 years thinking I really should repot those. Those are getting too big for what they're in, and of course something always comes up and today was the day. I have three different kinds of plants that I'm working on. Two of them I've got done already. Okay, so that would be the orchids. These were tiny little orchids that were stuck in tiny little pots like this, and they've been in there since we bought them. So I put them in here. I used the orchid mix, which is pretty much just some rocks and some pieces of charcoal, some bark. There's really nothing much to them. It's just something that holds the orchids in a container, and they get most of their nourishment from water and just the sunlight.
Do you use the ice cube?
I started to, but then I decided I know how much to water them.
Explain the ice cube method.
Some people say, and sometimes right on the label it says, put one ice cube on top of the soil or the potting mix once a week, and that's as much water as they possibly need.
And I know this, they're soaking them in water.
Yes, well, this potting mix was really, really dry, and it said I should have let it sit for 24 hours before I even decided to do this, but on my schedule that wasn't going to work, so I potted them. And now I'm letting them soak up as much water as they can for as long as I'm going to be out here.
So it kind of wicks
its way upward. Yes, and I poured it down through the top, so they've had a chance to soak it up so far.
Okay.
So they're sitting there. They're pretty much done. Well, then we had this aloe. I don't even know when we got this aloe or how big it was. But you know how aloes are. Here's the root ball, and yet this was falling out of the pot, and it had these two little ones off to the side.
Well, the weight had it, even the pot was tilted because,
I had rocks on one side. I mean, that's how long it's been since this poor thing has been in a good situation. So these guys are done now. I used for this one the potting mix for cactus, palm, and citrus. And this definitely has more soil to it than the orchids. So these, to me, these are done. And they did both have roots on them, so I'm not concerned about them. My wondering is, what should I do with this one? Are those roots coming out here? They almost look like it to me. If I cut it off here, could I just pot the rest of it in there? And I may ponder this for a day or so.
What if you were to take all of these off, because it is so curled?
Right.
And basically put all of that under soil.
So, like...
Yes, just removing all of these lower ones so that you have one long... because these are kind of mushy already.
Yes. Well, yeah, because they've... And, you know, are these roots even anything? How are they keeping it alive? It's really, really dry and the roots are kind of crispy. So I don't know. Maybe if somebody has an idea, I'm thinking cut it here and let these guys... which I think are roots, starting, take over.
Or was that from the flower?
It never flowered. It's an aloe.
Oh, okay.
So my aloe has never flowered. Some people's do.
Yeah.
They must treat them much better than I do.
Well, you know, we're an eclectic experimental garden. So I think you should just cut, whether you let it heal and then plant it.
I would, yes. Yes, and with healing, we mean just let it sit until the cut callus is over.
Right.
So it's telling the plant, I've started here, you can start making roots at this point because your roots fell off. Hmm. All right. Now, the one I'm most interested in repotting is this one. This is a Belgian hybrid orange bush lily. We have probably had this one for at least... we got this before we got our tree, our tricolor beech, from the same people. Yes. And this one, like clockwork, it blooms twice a year. And it has beautiful orange flowers that come out of, like, let me see. It would, suddenly you'd see that there was a bud coming through here, right between all of the leaves. And then it'll come up and it'll have this beautiful burst of orange, bright orange flowers that last for a long time, and then they're done. Well, this one now...
Look at that root system.
...is so amazing. I had to cut this out of the pot. It wasn't going to move at all. So I cut it out of the pot, and now I'm wondering, where am I going to divide this?
Well, I think you have to consider somewhere between, because these are newer, maybe you'll see something that, you know, but that would be one cut, and then over here would be another cut to separate it from the mother plant.
And maybe I can get this little one off, because I promised somebody I would give it.
I think you need some of those roots.
Yes. Yeah, hopefully I can figure out a division in the roots. These two, for sure, I will be putting in this pot. Unless you think this one's too big for them. And I should concentrate more on the big
one. Why don't you cut it first, and let's see what you end up with.
Okay. Here we go. Hold your breath. I'm not trying to kill you. I'm just trying to help you. Okay, here comes the moment of truth. Maybe. Okay, so now all of these are cut. But these are still attached on this side. So I've got to get it out of here.
Reminds me of spaghetti noodles.
Doesn't it? Who's still attached? Well, I think I'll put that whole clump in there, whether they're attached or not. And then they can decide amongst themselves.
Yeah, you can see some of them aren't, though. Might as well get rid of those or they'll just rot.
Like I said, I've never divided this one. It says to divide it every couple of years into clumps.
You may even be able to separate those. There you go.
Woohoo! That was exciting.
Now let's cut the other ones and see what you get.
Wiggle these. All right,
looking good.
I need to put these over here somewhere, out of my way. Okay. Now, going between the big ones. It belongs to these. Let's see if I can feel my way through here.
Yeah, maybe you won't even have to cut it.
No, they're definitely attached way down here at the bottom. You know what I was noticing the other day? I don't know what happened to those. Oh, right here. They were kind of making roots outside of where they are. See that? Those are hard. Those are almost root-like right there.
Yeah.
All right.
Maybe, well...
What do you think? Here?
Yep. Amazing root system.
Again, I'm just taking out some of these loose ones. And there's where it was connected to the babies. And this is where it was connected to the big one. Now, this is the original one, I believe.
Yep.
Okay, so that could go in that pot, don't you think?
Yeah, why not?
That's not going to be too big. Okay. Put yourself over here for the moment. Now let's see about these guys. Now these plants, according to the label, they like dry, sunny, but not bright. So if you have a...
Indirect?
Yeah, pretty much. I'll read you what it says, because it doesn't like sunny, but it likes bright.
Well, we have it in the south window.
We do.
And it seemed to be really happy there.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know where you're going to put all these containers in that south window.
I know. Sure enough, here it comes. It's coming loose.
Ta-da!
Look at that. Yay!
That'll be nice.
Yippee! Okay. Okay, so it says it likes partial to full shade. So even though it's in our south window, obviously the sun has to come through the window, come through the screen, and then get in there. So it says moderately growing from 1.5 to 2 feet tall and wide. It's not hardy in our area. It's only hardy in zones 9 through 11.
So you have to have this indoors.
So it has to be indoors. Right. And I hate to take things that are indoors and put them outdoors, because then they get bugs and stuff in them, and then when you bring them back, they're buggy. So, okay. That wasn't as bad as I thought.
So, are you going to be able to cut some of those roots back? You know, when you have a plant that is, you know, you're just releasing a new plant from a bucket,
right.
You know how the roots are kind of binded and so forth,
inside.
And
right.
How you release them?
As you can see, these are tangled. Well, let me see if I can pull on any that will easily come off, because then I know those don't need to be on there at all. Yep, like that one.
But you should be able to trim them, right?
Well, do I want to? Maybe just a little.
Think of it as me giving you a haircut.
To make me grow better?
Yes. I think I would remove some of the length of them.
Maybe like right here?
Yep.
For these, I'm using potting mix, and it's for indoor or outdoor. So obviously these are going to be indoor, but it doesn't matter.
Now you could remove that.
I'm taking these
bottom leaf
off,
right.
And this one. And while it grows, you can see this is where the flower was, how it comes up right between these leaves. So that was another interesting thing about this plant. So let me just see how deep I need to go. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to nestle all of this soil down between the roots.
And can you vibrate the pot a little bit?
Slightly moist, which is good. Just to help it get settled and seated into this pot, I'm just going to water it a little bit, and then I'll add more soil. And I'm going to cover up what I think was roots starting to come out. Those are the ones I showed you. So if they were indeed roots, they'll be in contact with the soil. Now this looks like it might be a little bit too much soil, but once I water it, it'll settle down, and I want it to have plenty of room. So you get the idea.
Now, would
what
you
has
use
to
a
be
stake
done
to help support
I could
it?
Help, yeah. Say sooner or later it'll probably get itself settled, but for now that's good. Okay, so on to the other plantings, and then we'll see how happy they are now that they have their new pots and new soil, new nutrients to thrive on. Well, we've got them all into their containers. We decided we had this bigger container, so we put the two in here, and then we put the singular one here.
Now that one you're giving as a gift.
Yes. Aaliyah, if you're watching, this one's yours. Hopefully it makes it and it's happy, and you'll be happy with it. Just a little more water in this one. Then these will go on the back porch, which will be sheltered from this wind for the next couple of days, just to make sure that they're all settled in before we take them into the house.
Well, I know you've been after this project for a long, 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 long time.
Every day you say, what is your goal for today? And I said, I am going to repot those houseplants. And it's not happened until today. And thank you for your help getting them planted. Once I opened that pot up, I just had to show you the root system of this Belgian lily. It was just so amazing. I've never seen anything like that before.
No.
If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. We would love to hear your comments, tips, questions, and if you'd like to become part of our garden family, there's a subscribe button over here, way over here. And there's also a little bell up at the top that will, if you click on it, it will notify you when we have a new video out. If you also want to just watch some more videos, go to wisconsingarden.com and you have your choice of over 1,000. And it'll keep you busy on a rainy day, perhaps.
Entertained.
Thank you so much. Be safe. Take care of yourselves, and glad you've watched. We appreciate you watching. Bye for now.
Connect with us on YouTube.